Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here to show you our newest t-shirt, and it is Sonic Toast Colors. If you like this design, follow the link in the description below to the Sonic Toast Spring Store and get one for yourself. There's not just shirts, but there's also stuff like canvas prints or puzzles or glasses or even Switch covers. So yeah, hope you find something you like, and on with the video. Toast!
Greetings, friends. It's me, Sonic Toast, and today we are looking at the Deluxe Bowser Battle Playset. I feel like this is like the big bad guy playset for the holiday. We got this one for Bowser, and we have the Death Egg for Dr. Robotnik in the Sonic Collection, which we'll be looking at later this week. So here's the back of the box. It's got Bowser and Mario on there. I don't know if it comes with Mario, that's why I pulled the Mario out. But yeah, we also have the Airship Deck playset and Diorama set, which I definitely gotta get those. I gotta find them still. But yeah. Let's see what this thing has to offer, as it looks like it has all kinds of different actions, like the axe that comes down and Bowser somehow dies from it. All right, so here's how it looks out of the box. We have instructions, cardboard, and a background. And here are all the pieces, including the Bowser figure, who looks like he's trapped in there. Let me out! All right, so I went ahead and cut all the ties loose. Let's see what we got here. This appears to be lava. That's cool, I like that. And this is a platform of some kind. Here is the Bowser figure. I believe it's the same one we've gotten before. Although, I feel like this one looks better. Is it different? And then we've got the main platform, which is one big piece and has the bridge on there too, with some extra stuff here that I don't know what it is yet. All right, so here's the background that it comes with. Very nice, the big Bowser statue. It's a little floppy, but not super floppy. Very black on the back. And here is the button that you press that makes the axe go down. And then, oh, I see. The bridge goes up, axe goes down, down goes the bridge. Neat. All right, now before we get to the assembly, I gotta know if this is a new Bowser sculpt. So this is actually the old one that came with Bowser's Castle and Peach's Castle. And here is the new one. And I already see some major differences. See, the old one has some eyebrow problems. You see that big spot right here by the eyebrows? You can see a big line there. And the new one does not have that. The new one is lighter colors, different plastic it feels like. Let's see, how's the jaw? It still has that, you know, like weird line on the jaw there, but I don't think it's as dominant as it is on this one. Yeah, so different colors there. The new one is just looks better. I think he's a little bit smaller, actually, than the original one. A teeny bit less bulky. Yeah, new Bowser, like, it's hard to tell the difference, but the new one is better quality, much less paint errors. I don't know if it's really even painted. I think they use the colored plastic to put this one together, whereas this one obviously has paint, was painted. You can see all kinds of paint errors on it. So another big thing is you can see the assembly line on Bowser's face here. We see that on a lot of Bowser figures, and I'm not seeing that here on the new one. So it is pretty cool that even though they didn't have to, they are continuing to improve the look of their figures. And then this is a minor thing, but the old one, the texture on the skin is much more dominant, much more rough. The new one, it still has the texture, but it's a lot smoother, which isn't necessarily a good thing. But yeah, look at the shells. You can definitely see a difference in the shells there. All right, this is the first part you assemble with these black bars here, which allows you to slide the background in to the platform. And then it appears we're able to just stick the bridge right there in the hole of that platform. And then from there, we get the lava, I believe, goes here. I'm guessing here because I don't feel like the instructions it came with are very instructive. So there, that's how it looks. So we have a lot of lava at the bottom covering up most of the playset. And then we have the bridge at the top. So let's just raise our camera a little bit, get a little higher here. And then we have Bowser standing on the bridge. facing off against Mario. Bum, bum, bum. Wow, and yeah, their Bowser figure is still just way too small. As a matter of fact, they've made him even smaller. Anyway, here we go, final battle. What? Oh no, it's a Bowser. What do I do? Well, he can't shoot fire and he's really small, so I'll just hop right over him. Here I go. Woohoo! Mario jumps over Bowser and hits the button, chopping Bowser in the back, and drowning him in fire and lava. This hurts so much, lava bath. He comes back up as Dry Bowser. Why have they not made a Dry Bowser toy yet? Yeah, there, that is how that works. So fun. This does feel a little repetitive because the Bowser's Castle playset already kind of had somewhat of a bridge scene, final boss scene, but it was much, much smaller. So this is on a larger scale. And of course, we can use any number of larger Bowser figures to make him more intimidating. So yeah, this is kind of a fun little final boss playset. Although I do find it a shame that the lava seems to cover up most of the platforms here because they do look really good. I do think they did a good job on doing this part of the playset. But yeah, it looks cool. Not super necessary, I would say. It's not like you're getting a whole world. You're just getting one scene from the final world. But yeah, if I had room in my set of Mario dioramas, I would definitely add this in as the final boss. And who knows, maybe I will someday.
But yeah, here's something cool. It actually has a little lever on the side here. So by lifting that lever, you bring the bridge right back up and it clicks right into place. And then you can do it all over again. I guess you just gotta be careful when you hit the button because it can just as easily kill Mario as it can Bowser. Wah, wah.
And wouldn't you know it, I almost forgot to put batteries in. So once you turn it on with batteries, you get these lights down below that make the lava look a little cooler. I guess some of them flash. I'm seeing some of them fade out and then come back in. See that? I guess that's supposed to give the lava some kind of a glowing lava effect. I do think the red light reflecting off of Bowser himself looks really cool. And you know, maybe if we turn the lights off, it would look even cooler. Let's see. There. That's how it looks with the lights off. Oh, dang it. My computer is shining there. One sec. So there. That's how it looks with the lights completely off. Kind of neat. Kind of a cool little effect. So there is that. And we're supposed to get sound effects too. So let's hear it. Wow, that's kind of neat. And it appears that once the bridge is down, you don't get any more sound effects. Bring the bridge back up, killed Mario, and... neato. Let's see, where's the power switch? Turn it off. And Bowser screams. Turn it back on. And he roars. Is that the only time we hear that roar sound effect for him? Because... oh, wrong one. No. Is there anything else that triggers a sound anywhere? I don't think so. Huh. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I like it. So friends, thanks for watching this quick little review of the Deluxe Bowser Battle playset. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Do you need this for your collection or are you gonna pass on it altogether? This one is $40 at Target, probably because it's a bit larger in scale. So there we go. Have a fantastic day and toast.